You're a comedian.
No, it's out there. I mean, you know,
you're a comedian. You know, I can remember. I think you can go back to the beginning, to day one of my. And you know, I like to touch on this subject. Day one of my career, my first fight. Because when Dana White, my Uncle Jeff Mayweather, we taught Dana White about, I think that's when Dana White used to work for us, when he used to be with us. When he used to work for us, Dana White. Yeah, when nobody else knew who Dana White was, when he was this little square white guy, before he cut his hair off and became a tough guy in the MMA. He was a little square guy, he used to run around with me and ask me to wear, nobody would wear his patch. You know, I said, I'll do it for free. A little Budweiser patch, I done it for free. You know, showed him love. And I'm proud of him. I'm proud of, you know, how far he has come.
That's funny. It's almost like they're using your name to publicize themselves. Everybody in MMA wants to fight you, and everybody, you, Dana White can't stop mentioning you.
You know, I've always was taught this, you know. You know, because I'm in the $100 million business. Not the $100,000 business. You know, when you shouldn't even, I shouldn't even be stooping to certain levels. You know, stooping to certain levels because it don't make any sense. People that's in the MMA, I wish them nothing but the best. I don't have anything negative to say about them. You know, the hand I was dealt in life, I was dealt the royal flush. And I just have to be thankful and appreciative for the hand that I was dealt. I have anything negative to say about anyone. You know, I wish everyone nothing but the best.
Well, you said you wore his patch for free to help him out.